Howdy folks, it's RJ Helms here, back with episode 3 of City Skylines After Dark. Pretty much as soon as I put the cut in for recording the last episode, I got this pop-up here saying that we've reached our next milestone, which is Busy Town, population 3600. It unlocks a whole lot of really interesting things, and especially a lot of the content that seems to be new in After Dark, so that's pretty cool. I was going to put this on hold and maybe pick up recording in another day or two, but with this here, I think I might as well just keep going through, because there's a lot of cool stuff here that shows off the new content. So it unlocks city planning policies, level 4 unique buildings, leisure and tourism unique buildings, which is new, the commercial specialization for tourism, which is new, the bike ban on sidewalks, which is new, as well as a couple other policies. And a bunch of the new, a bunch of the old road types, two-lane roads, sound barriers, a couple of the fancier four-lane roads. Basically, this is the extended 2-4 and 6-lane roads, but see, 2-lane road with bike lanes, 4-lane road with bike lanes, 6-lane road with bike lanes. These four things are all old, but then here we get into a bunch of the other new content. So, bus station, jet ski rental, fishing pier, fishing tours, marina, riding stable, skate park, beach volleyball court, and restaurant pier. So that's a whole bunch of new After Dark content, which I think we should spend some time playing with. So to that end, I think I want to reconsider some of my districting and maybe make kind of the area south of this this road be a tourism district. I think that is a good way to spend our time. So I'm going to create a new district down here. I'm going to do exactly that. Kind of butt right up against the road like this. I'm going to use the small tool to neaten it up. Just like so. Just like that, and then you can keep going out to here. Just like that. Beautiful. In this district, I am going to give the tourism specialization, and we'll see what happens. I think a bunch of my commercial zones will start disappearing and being replaced. Yep, we're seeing that happen. That's pretty cool. Let's put down some of these special tourism buildings. I don't know how much of riding stables is appropriate in that neighborhood. Let's put a skate park down there. Let's put down some of these other buildings. I think a fishing tour, a marina, and a restaurant pier are all pretty cool. Gonna have to rebuild the road to them, but let's do that. Nice and quick-like. I can make this work. I'll probably make this all commercial too once it's done. Yeah, so let's complain about a lot of lack of water, because I'm actually out of water. Yeah, and then all this spare space down here can be made commercial. Unpause. And sort out our water situation. I want to move this guy down as well, just so they're all a bit farther away from my now leisure district. Power him up. Build some more power because we're running low. Another one of those guys should do the trick. We are still out of water. There we go. Those look a little weird. They're kind of high above the hills. That sounds a-okay to me. Alright, so the change to residential is actually, or the change to the tourism specialization has actually sucked up all of our demand for commercial. Which is pretty cool. No one's taking our taxis. Didn't think they would. So I do want to improve this road, just because it's part of my longer-term plan. Police station can go on that road. And as such, I kind of want to limit access to this road. So I'm just going to axe... Oh, that was too much. Every other intersection. Yeah, just like that. Now I can fill this back in. Like so. And the reason for that was just because major streets get bogged down pretty badly by too many intersections, especially now that I'm getting traffic lights on these streets. So keeping every other intersection, just keeping the space out, so these are going to be kind of 20 tiles apart rather than every 10, makes a lot more sense. And then with that in place, I'm going to start, well, I was going to say I'm going to start putting down some bus infrastructure, but I don't quite have the money for it, so I'll come back to that in a little bit. How is this doing? This looks like it could eventually deal with being turned into a real interchange and extending this highway over. Which I could do if I bought that tile. I do really like the long-term vision of having this curve over and cross to the other side of this waterway here. But that's probably getting ahead of ourselves. I don't need to buy a new tile just yet. There's still plenty of space here. I'm just going to extend this down, keep up this pattern. But with this one, curve a little bit more aggressively away. Join up with that street. But there's no real demand for residential or commercial right now, so I'm not going to build that just this second. Instead, let's, what are you saying? Not enough educated workers. Okay, that's expected. I don't get more. I've got good educational coverage. This is pretty sleepy, but I imagine a lot of this will turn into commercial as the time comes. But for now, I need to build some more industry. Do you want to keep, do you want to extend the industrial park over here or the agricultural area? I think the agricultural area. Here's what I'll do. Got a good thing going with this pattern. I can eventually build a rail terminal over here. Seems like a great place for it. In the interim, put down a couple more little roads here and extend this industrial area. I think this one will go to everything that doesn't actually have its exit onto this main road like that. That covered with water. I've got plenty of water and plenty of power. Crank up the speed and watch that develop. I think as far as districts go, I want this one to end right at this street. So I'll pull the small brush down over here, like so, but then back up all the way over to here. Yep, and there we go. That's how you do it. Cool, I've got plenty more demand. No, not industrial, residential over here. Fill in some of those gaps that I had. That sewage pump out of the way, I can fill some of this in. That's all perfectly reasonable. Now let's think of filling some of this stuff in. I'm not going to build residential right along this street because it's a bit close to the garbage dump. But down on this block, I can extend all this out. Just like that. Throw in the odd little cross line there. check up on our services, so you're gonna need an elementary school. Good for fire. Yeah, you could do with another cop shop as well. Good for garbage, of course. Healthcare you're fine for, or deathcare you're fine for, but you're gonna want another. Clinic. Why are you guys getting abandoned? Worker education was too low. Yep, that's fine. Just gonna have to deal for now. Okay, and let's hopefully get some more cash coming in here. Because, well, I know cash is coming in. But I am vastly under leisure service. Which I'm going to want to deal with as soon as possible. I think a plaza with trees over here makes a lot of sense. Large playground over there makes a lot of sense. Start getting a bunch of these guys just out of far into the red zone, which is nice. Up there, another little park. Okay, I've got one more thing down here. I'll kind of be in the zone that's survivable. Not necessarily pretty, but yeah, I'm gonna shove one of these parks in here. So some improvements to be made. I have no recreation or leisure over in the industrial park. Yeah, but my happiness is pretty good. A couple things are really unhappy. Why is that? Well, because no one lives there. That's a good reason not to be happy. Still having worker education problems. Not too much I can do about that. Okay, so yeah, I think public transit is a good thing to start thinking about pretty soon. Kind of what I envision is one route along this road. One route up this road, and probably call it there. To that end, it'd be a good idea to kind of close this loop up. If that's been defined as the main road. This is pretty cool. Grow the city. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. You want to come in just like that. Sweet. Yeah, that's a pretty logical extent, I think. Neighborhood, you know. I was saying, kind of up onto this hillside. Out to there. Oh, no, that's not what I wanted to do. just like that. Oh, what did I just do? Oh, this view's rejiggered too. Makes sense. Yeah, and then in the fullness of time, there could be another highway exit onto this road. Upgrade this as well. Yeah, and I can have a... In the long term, have a freight train stop over here. And that all makes a lot of sense. Until then, however... Think about keeping these neighborhoods alive and growing. Like, that's pretty logical. Once again, I'm only going to do residential on the inside of these loops just because I don't think I want it. But it's so close up against these industrial parks, or industrial area. Still doing fine for power, for water. Do with another elementary school. I'm gonna need another high school in a moment or two. Another fire station. I've ever seen any bicyclists yet. I'm curious. Oh, there's one. Drives me crazy that they have them biking on the sidewalk. There's a guy using that path. That's what I wanted to check, is if cyclists were using this path, and it seems that they are. Yeah, abandoned because of worker education. That seems to be the same old story in all of these. Leisure or tourism areas that I built. Maybe a taxi stand down here makes sense too. I've got the space to spare. Yeah, just right up there. Not enough educated workers. You need two highly educated workers. The gym. Well, I guess that makes sense. Okay, I'm just gonna slow on down here because I wanna be mindful of the need for building up some cash to build those services that I kind of falling behind on. What's our next milestone? 5,500, and that'll probably get us some more money. Oh, and a bunch of cool stuff. Prisons, metros, yeah. All good things. Those fields are very chartreuse. I don't know about that. But we are still in the realm of needing more... residential areas, so let's... see what we can do for that. That's a little ugly. I don't think that quite worked the way I wanted it to. Okay, I can make this work though. That comes out like that. That comes out like that. And these two guys join up. Out of bulldoze mode, like so. Still feels a little stupid. That feels less stupid. I don't think there'd be any point in having this road. Sure. Alright, let's fill this in. And leave that open once again, because I don't want people living right next door to the poop pump. You can come down like so. Since I'm leaving that open, that'll be fine. With any luck, I can delete these power lines. Get a bit of infill. Yeah, and it's going to stay powered. Beautiful. Okay, where to next? I mean, I've got space kind of reserved here for commercial areas that I'm not getting demand for. Because my tourism zone hasn't fully developed yet. Did that improve my tax use? No, it didn't. Okay, but I've got money for a bus depot. I'll slap down on the other side of the taxi depot. Let's put down some routes. I don't know, there is the bus station, which is really cool, and I'm going to want to make use of those, but I don't know how it works. This is all new to me. Oh, there's some cabs whizzing around. That's pretty cool. Nope, that doesn't look good. I am out of power. Yeah, out of power. Well, another one of these guys. Find a place that makes 20 milliwatts, or megawatts, there we are. So hopefully bus routes will work without the need for these, stations. Looks like they work fine. So there's one bus route kind of crossing the town this way. Try one up crossing the town this way. I am gonna miss, I'm certain, the mods for the transit management. There's the one that changes the colors of your routes automatically and gives them a name. I think maybe it's all the same one, the extended public transport UI or whatever. I think that's going to be the biggest one that I'm going to miss. right off the hop now that I'm getting into this. Well, let's just give this guy a different color. Just so I can tell them apart, line one and line two. Oh, yeah, there is the line activity, day, night, and day and night. That's kind of cool. I don't know how much I'm going to need it. Oh, there we are. We got two transit routes. Yeah, see, I think a station here in the long term might make a lot of sense. I could split this in half to one route here and one route there. Because now that I think about it, it might be appropriate to have a stop up here as well. Yeah. Yeah, see, splitting this in half seems pretty logical, having one route go this way and one route go that way. But we'll deal with that later. I think some of these guys can have this. I don't want to go all the way down to the poop. Up to there is probably fine. Place is absolutely crawling with trucks. And they have to go all the way over there. So maybe building the new interchange up here and having some development might make a lot of sense. Last one from Toronto. Not all of these, I don't know what the hell that is. Oh, it's getting a change, that makes sense. But you know, like this diverging diamond might make a lot of sense here. My simple intake and outtake, let's build that. So I need to axe a bunch of this highway, probably a bunch of this rail line. Yep, just like that. Destroy that guy. See if I can't have this just connect up with this. I mean, I'm sure I can, but yeah, it's a question of where the slope's gonna work out. That's pretty cool. Don't need to worry so much about the other side of it just yet. Let's pull this highway over and join her up. Like so, and you can come down and like that. It's a little weird, but it'll work. Oh, not enough money. That's kind of a problem. Alright, there's that. Okay, but money's absolutely pouring in, so I can finish this up pretty quickly. That thing looks a little insane if you ask me. But it works. There's a couple other things I want to do. One, fix this, because that's totally unnecessary. Slope? What slope? Oh, that slope, I guess. And I can't fix that rail line just yet. And let's see about simplifying this, because I feel like I have things I don't need. Let's see, if you're going up this way, come off there, or you can get on there. No, I'll leave it. It's a tiny little neighborhood that's going to service on that side. But I am totally content to leave it as it. And in fact, I'm going to build that tiny little neighborhood. This is just going to be conventional industry. It's going to be a nice little isolated pocket of it. Oh, this is ugly. But it'll do. Come on, filthy industry. Don't let me down. Connect up a couple of these roots to it. For now, you can just be regular roads. Everything's gonna be feeding out to this exit to the highway, so until that gets going crazy, I don't think I need to worry about other infrastructure in here. Let's see how you are as far as services. My biggest fear at this point is this isn't going to be cost effective. For want of all the services I'm not providing. Let's put down some high schools, speaking of services, or a high school. Starting to get some commercial demand, so let's pop some stuff down in the bases we reserved for that. Well, this is shaping up pretty well. May soon be time to actually, I think it's time to rationalize this. I was gonna say, this is going to be a bottleneck, so if I actually just... upgrade all this stuff. You're gonna have to move a single tile over. And you, the police station, can you go down there? Be here. Kinda have to be there. But if you move down a little bit, you can move down a little bit. And you can be upgraded. You can be changed to make sense. And you can just come right off there. This upgrade in place. Fill in some of this stuff. I'm not really sure about this, but that should flow a lot better. You folks are complaining about being hard up for people. But I think this is a good place to wrap up this episode. Once again, no, let's push through to get to Big Town and then we'll end the episode. That makes sense. We're super close. I want to be mindful of this rail line, which I still have to make sense out of. But for now, I can put in some residential zoning. You guys fill in that loop there. I'll leave some of that free just in case the rail line makes living there unpleasant. Good enough. There we are. Okay, cool. So, Big Town, population 5,500. So that is the fifth milestone? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 milestone. Okay, cool. So we have new areas and taxation policies. We unlock the metro. And then with level 5 buildings, those are all old. Leisure specialization, which is new. My cats are causing some trouble again. And we have, okay, education boost, a bunch of other things which we know about. But some new ones, harsh prison sentences. Double the usual prison sentences, but reduces the crime rate. I assume that means I've unlocked prison here as well. Let go of leisure. Leisure specialized area, stop generating tax income. They'll get a healthy boost in their entertainment and attractiveness values. All right, high res residential, high density residential, high density commercial, and the office zone as per usual. Incineration plant, metro station, university as per usual, and also the prison. A prison is a correctional facility to transform criminals into law-abiding citizens. Police stations have jails to hold criminals for a short time, but a prison is needed to rehabilitate them. Okay, cool. But we can start dealing with that. I think having offices will help. The university as well, so we can do pretty well as far as our educational capacity, because that is remaining a bit of a problem. But we can do all that in the next episode. So I see one last thing. Are people like, oh, 10 taxis, 217 citizens per week. That's all pretty cool. But yeah, so we'll deal with all that in the next episode. So until then, this... Alright, that's the pollution of the garbage dump. Okay, so until then, this has been City Skyline After Dark Episode 3. I've been RJ Helms, so thanks so much for watching. As always, please leave your feedback in the comments below. Anything that you have to say about this, anything you think I'm doing well, anything you want to see me try. I am just learning this as I go along, because this is all pretty new to me with the expansion. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more things like this. And I'll see you all in the next episode. Thanks so much.